So, welcome everybody. It's really nice to see a full room of people. And so, I have the same line here. So, my name is Marek Denko, and I'm a 3D artist from. Do you hear me? Well, my voice is a little shaky, so a lot of you here. So thankful to be here, to have a chance to participate to this event, and computer graphics was always my main hobby and things I did professionally for my whole life since I finished the studies, and my main tool sets are 3ds Max and V-Ray. I use other not so important things like Photoshop. Today I live in Czech Republic, and I run a small studio called No Emotion, which is in Prague. And yes, I'm recognized by the community because of my personal artwork, so that's what I'm going to talk about today. So I will try to start about my background, and I'll try to give you some advices and tips and maybe inspire you who has the ambition to create his own art. So how did I get into the CG? I was born in 1980, so I'm 37 now, and it was a really small town in the Slovak Republic. No computers whatsoever there, but after Iron Curtain went down, first wave of technology started to stream into our countries, and I was able to get my hands on Atari, and this was my setup. So you see, I pulled these images from the internet. It's exactly the same, broken joysticks and other stuff like that. Some first game I played, older guys can relate, Bruce Lee and Pole Position. I was very happy that my mother told me all my school grades went down. I did some basic coding and stuff like that, but not very important. But it was good stuff. So after I was not in high school, my mother bought us the 486 computer, 2 megabytes of RAM. And some guys from our town, it was like 3,000 people in the neighborhood, but I knew like 4 guys had the computers, so we started to do some. We became friends, did some LAN parties, and then traveling with all the screens, the car. And one day I came to the friend's house, and his father was playing with the 3D studio. It looked like this, it's for MS-DOS. And I was like, oh man. And he told me, it's not even true that the Terminator 2 was done in this one. So I was like, oh, I have to try it. So he made me a copy. First crack experience. and we had a lot of those. And I started to learn. I didn't speak English at all. So all I did was just use the translator. I translated all the stuffs and started to learn by trial and error. Some of my very early images, I mastered the lens flare. because Babylon 5, I mastered the volumetric fog. So volumetric lights and mirror map and all that kind of stuff. So this is from 1999, I don't know if you can see. So it's pretty ancient. So then I went to the university in Brno in Czech Republic. I studied civil engineering, and it was really first time I got the chance to connect to the internet via the library in the school. So I set up my first email account, and I saw that there is already some CG community emerging in the Czech Republic and also around the world. So I joined and met a lot of people in the town. Sort of talk. We met with all V-shirt settings, and every time there was something, it was different back then. It was under inclusion, weren't there. You know, every time some feature was there, we tested even Yes, in global illumination, in final render, glow, depth of field, all kind of brazzy renders, some image-based lighting. It was a new thing back then, so. At least for us. So, 3D depth of field. But in brazzy render, it took like 7 hours to render. This is the final resolution. So, so a lot of small tests and learning how to it's a lot about artists, so I couldn't help myself and show you some of my oldest artist projects, usually for friends, classmates, they did some school projects. It was sometimes for money, but mostly for beer and some other stuff, so I see it's state of the art. I mean, could you do this today, right? Yes, the guy with the broken leg. some bigger stuff. Yeah, this is me. So that was my setup, and 17-inch screen. It's my this is my favorite pose even today. So one bucket, in Final Render. So these are the images from when I was on the university. I just want to show some old stuff. So this is Moonlight People, and it was the first image I had. It was printed in a French magazine, and my first 3D total front page, which was a sort of little milestone for me. So I get to know people knew me a little bit better. Inspiration pretty much like Lord of the Rings and Cathedral, the movie from Tom Babinski, and Warcraft, whatever, student life. And then I did this female anatomy study, and for a long time it was one of my most popular images, maybe because she was just naked and really all the dances. If you look at the art station, you see that only this kind of stuff is drawing from a page. sexist. so it started as a modeling training. We always wanted to do everything, basically, so environment, scar modeling, characters. I was young, I was full of energy, I wanted to try everything and have some sort of complete portfolio, because there was a myth that you have a lot of things in portfolio, like from each segment of the market, and so you became more successful. But that wasn't the reason. I just want to test it out and see. So here I apply the model. I already knew that the nudity is a good way to promote the work. So clickbaits. but then I had some thinking with something else, and it wasn't that successful. So this is from the time I was traveling between cities, take a train, and I saw this old lady. I had a new Olympus camera. I don't know the megapixels, but imagine 2004. So then I returned and I checked the lighting. I just was sorting my photos and I saw the picture, so I said, let's do it, let's see what I can do. And then I returned back, checked the lighting, give the lady some money, made my girlfriend to take a picture. And so the point of this one showing is that a lot of my works are just remaking the real stuff. As you will see, it's a very good practice. I'll show you a lot of smaller tests I did. So you see here all kind of stuff, some lighting tests, and I do some things like this even today. I just don't show them. I can't because I have a portfolio, so I don't know. So a lot of stuff like this, I get a lot of intuition and materials from these, and learn a lot when you are creating pictures. So this is the render. I had a little picture. I simulated some HDR from the windows. I just had a plane. I took a picture of the window. Okay. Yeah, waiting for spring. This is also from the time I was living in Bratislava. Again, I took a picture of the car and I said, oh, nice. There was no like displacement, like weird displacement. Back then there was a microframe displacement for the week of the final render, but it was crappy and slow. So this was done with the displaced approximation modifier. The ancient stuff maybe is not even there anymore. And yes, as I was saying, I was in charge. So before I tried character as some environments and let's do this. So it was also quite successful and its background is not like the. This is the first spherical map, possibly the last one I did. So it's a street, even so there's some reflections going on. Yeah, again, I made my girlfriend take a picture. Yeah, full of energy. Yeah. So because of that render, I got this job. This is the Mitsubishi Eclipse. It was brand new. This is rendered in Brazil render. And I'm showing just because that I posted on CG Talk and it got banned like after a few hours because some guy from Mitsubishi thought that I stole some materials from Mitsubishi, that is some, I had to explain that it's a joke. You know, and it was a good way to say you did good. So, yeah, and then I created my first demo reel. I just played. So it's made from my animation inside a little of those and some ripoffs of Matrix and KDLab stuff. Totally not So, memories. It was the first image I created in V-Ray. It was created on a laptop and all started as a display test on the ground. I just wanted to test the V-Ray display scan feature and I was playing around with it. And then just, okay. I have written here that it's made of elements for my life, sort of. But yeah, some display test turned into something which really shaped my career later on, because I got noticed even more because of this image. And some of my friends, as I was working as an environment artist in there, I started to focus more on the environment and testing how far I can go full 3D without ray tracing being like super slow. This is the case, so super slow. I was even using 3 gigabyte switch, if you know what I'm talking about. This is inspired by a movie. It's written here that I will talk about inspiration, but it's really hard to say who inspired someone. I just look, I see, I do. So at the time, company where I work was going south of south, so I started another demo reel. And it was a time where everyone was doing demo reels, so I took time and created my next one. Mostly saw the great part. So this is a kind of inspiration from that. I wasn't like depressed, but after Milan, we live in a nice area. We went to area which is close to this one. So this is called What Took You So Long. So even some bad mood can be inspirational. Hector, here the main challenge was the vegetation. I don't know if scattering tools were like a thing back then, but this is like placed by hand, of course, instances and stuff like that. Some Mad Max inspired stuff. For this one, when you do a like, nice model, I wanted to show it more to the audience because we have more environments, you can play with the model and show more angles. It will catch the eye a little bit more. This is called El Dorado, and it started. I have a lot of questions about soil, so I will just answer them. So there's no like real displacement. It's all scattered geometry, and I have scattered geometry on the scattered geometry. Some details here, also the black dots and the hairs and stuff like that. Those are around a billion polygons, but really just ate it with no problem. So my son destroyed this car, so I created it for him. And when I was taking pictures, I realized that the front bumper was already missing. So I had to order a new one to see, and I gave it to him so he can destroy it just a little bit so I can see. So again, a pretty like a simple setup, but you can really put a lot of details in it. That's what I like to do. This is inspired by a picture. All of my inspiration actually came when I'm sorting pictures. I have like, a ton of folders with unsorted photos, so I'm sorting them, and I saw this picture of my girlfriend, and then this is in Bratislava, with a bus station or something. So I just wanted to test it out. I created just the setup, similar to this one, and then just changed everything, basically. There was a time I started to use like seriously like fog in the scene directly without compositing and depth of field and all kind of stuff like that. So it's all in one pass and there is no... It just looks more than that, you know. This is not linear workflow yet, but it will come there. Some details, the two-polar plane was actually a pain in the ass. This part, like, hands off to engineers who draw the stuff, because this was pain. Even from this size, the last demolition show. Thank you. other than a lot of camera work, it's sometimes over the top, but try to keep it short when you're doing memorials. You should like not do it like 5 minutes because usually people won't watch it, I suppose. Biggest pain here, I just shoot some slides. I'm still talking about the memorial. So, the biggest pain was transferring cameras from one scene to another because everything was in different units. So sometimes I had inches, you know, sometimes I didn't care, I just created walking, do my stuff, you know. Then I thought, oh, that's a unit, so. So, the camera was pain. Yeah. And it was really well received. And I did it like already having 2 kids and wife while freelancing at home, so it's crazy. But I am in like half of my presentation. I'm going to through my more recent works very quickly, and then I will show you a few like more detailed making of something I chose for you. This is just to remind you that I did something like this, so if you meet me outside or after this presentation, maybe you can ask about any of these, and I will answer any questions you might have. This is the making of video, I won't play it now. Just to remind you that the preparation is high, maybe. And I can talk about any of these. That is like 15 or 10 minutes. So, want some inspiration, some stuff here. IRS products. Maybe I can talk later about the ice, snow, ground, water transition, and how we rebuild materials are really good for some things. Yeah. So I'm going to talk about the eventual hesitation. And yeah. So during the summer of 2016, it's all written here, so I just. I came across this beautiful Volkswagen transport parking in California with the house where the English teacher of my daughter lives. It's a nice sentence. So the summer came, I just went there and drive, and I saw this car parked there. You can actually find it on the street view there, you know. And yeah, so I was like, oh, this looks like something I could do. So I took a few pictures and I started modeling. Like not, I'm not that like, oh, this is nice. I didn't start like the minute I came home. Okay. So I started to play with the model, and yeah, I found out that this car is a lot like custom made because this is transportation. The roof shouldn't be even there. They have different types of these cars, so I really had no choice just to call the guy and ask him for more pictures. He was very friendly, he's actually American, which is surprising to me. In Czech Republic, in some small village, okay. Maybe he's hiding. I played the making of video, I will see the boring parts, and image. So this is the modeling phase, really basic setup for lighting and just adding details, checking out how they look. And I put it on the hill, tried to play with some forest park. Didn't like it that much because the canvas was so big and I'd like to play with details a little bit more. So I changed the scenery, I pulled some old buildings from old projects and put some scene together with a few camera angles, and then I find the one I like. I start to put details in the scene and finish it. So now little bit more in detail. So the inspiration was clear. Then when I already knew that it would be like a city scenery, like early morning, so I searched for some references. I seen the references before, so these were sort of my like, you know, more references, but these were the favorite one I picked for the this presentation. And so the workflow, or how you call it, I usually mock the scene. This time we started with model, but for example, for the Robert image, I just created the gray boxes and checked the composition a little bit and set the camera, set the lighting, and then I browse the internet for the references. I go with the modeling, texturing, shading, the render region, time lapse, just for fun. But you can see the final state of your model directly in the final lighting, so there is no better proof. Also, that's why I'm doing those. But I also doing that because it's nice to see the afterward, you know, the progress and stuff. Here, I'd like to talk about some technical issues I have to face. And the scene is pretty big, and architecture is always you that, you know, you can have like 20 kilometers. But this is big, okay? See. So the depth of field was there, 3D depth of field, and light count is pretty high. It was before the it's a brute force. When I checked, I have my cell machines, 6, so it wasn't a big deal to distribute the render. And the details on the shading, on the car, you see mouse? Yeah, so it was just better, so I just, why not, let's see. So that was slow too, and there is a V-Ray fog in there, and it's a lot of indirect lighting, and there is a bad steam, so everything is reflecting everything, and especially when I was testing the ground. When I was testing the ground, I really had to have the everything in there to see the shader, you know, no noise, because you know, if it is noisy, you just see noise. So I needed to really see what's going on in some regions. You can see the area, but it's not even sampled properly yet. I blurred it a little bit, just to say it was much more noisy. Yeah, and the worst thing I faced was the... I really tried to do the complex in directly from the render, so it's a red light, but all the street lamps. And the main thing was that when I had already some light set up, okay, so, which I was happy with. So the foreground was mainly set, but I wanted to have a nice diffuse contribution, reflection, long streaks, and a nice bokeh. So I really had no other choice. I tested a lot. So I created 3 lights for each light. One was doing the diffuse part, one was doing the reflection part. They have all different intensities. And there was just one visible camera, which was for the bokeh thing. So that was slow too. Another thing, which was the V-Ray fault, some cutoffs on the reflections. Like I wanted to have these really long lines of light. With some intensity, just the line just disappeared. Even the cutoffs were already on the zero value. So, but I found a way around it, just to increase all the light intensities, and then in the end, just put the exposure of the render down and multiply the same, and light reflections was already there. Yeah, very good use of V-Ray blend for the, you know, all the shit. It has like 4 layers, I think, like the white parts, yellow parts, dark parts. It's all. I work mainly with masks. I don't like to like create diffuse texture, and then it's like masked stuff, one on top of each other. Also the water drops and they're visible. Yeah, so it's there, like basically, you know, everything. Yeah. Some references collection, also a lot of research, which is invisible, but it's there. And, yeah. Me, some details of the machines. That usually just hand broken. I just slice the mesh and then just lay it on, just simply the draw the line and then quadrify it and shell on it, serve the edges and display them some. I didn't care how they look like from the top. I just wanted to have nice thing in the render. Some details here. The interior of the lights. This is how the scene look from the. It's the first time I'm showing this actually. You'll be surprised to see my scenes like from the back. Even like all the bands grabbing like so funny. So you see some this kind of stripes there. Camera somewhere is this is the gap between the wheels. And I was shading each part separately. So even the rendering is so slow. So for example, one part is this one, another part. So that's why those stripes are there. I was shading them like separately. So it was easier. And another, this is how the scene looks. So some buildings here, from all the projects, buildings here, big gap, okay, this is behind the car. And another thing, something here, these are for reflections of the car, and these lights are all like hand placed, just to be there for the reflections here. And, sounds crazy, but you know, all the time in the world, so. The main sponsor is a monster. Next one I'm going to talk about is a souvenir. I had a lot of online questions about this one. Maybe you are not interested, but I will go with it. So, it's a EDM, it was for my kids, not from the beginning, but I like to think it was from the start. So it's inspired by the picture. It's, I took it during some summer when I was sleeping and I woke up and I see this already sunset. So I took a picture, it was in my wife's parent house. So yeah, some nice reference versus final image. Shade, this is the first setup I did. I put the Eldorado in there. I was about to model the Ferrari actually. I changed my mind and tried to put something not realistic in there. The thinking process was that if I put something unrealistic there, that it won't be like discarded as a picture immediately by the general audience. So there is something at least to take out as something. So again, reference the first setup, other details, you know, played with it, the book, and especially out of this one, which is completely out of focus in the end. I really like it. This is like, I really loved it, like, my good job. So then I changed the angle, and I hated it immediately. Now I hate it even more. Even more props, and you know, see even the size of the book that changed, and some dust, here the dust, as you can see here. Those questions are most often about the dust and the lighting, so I'll cover those. Some surface materials here, very handy. Yeah. Details. The screen grab from the G Studio. Yeah, so. Few crops, there is a dust. I don't have a direct view on the dust. Some people, maybe less skilled, they think that there's something you have to do for the dust, but really just if it's there, it's there, period. You just have to do it. Right? So, the acoustics here was a thing here. So here is the detail of dust, just splines scattered around. Not even multi-scattered, of course, but it was just enough RAM, so I just put it on the object and scatter it with the compound, scatter some settings, and it was enough. The dust is basically on everything which is in the focus of the camera. Even on the car. It's not even maybe you can find something. Yeah, see. He's disappointed. Just to show that the object on the detail of the edge of the shell. I'm from Peron now, so that's all right. Now this is the edge of the which I'm so proud of. Here it was like a combination of the easy brush and a lot of like 30 takes. Nothing you want to do in the production. I won't talk about it. Detail of the paint area. And the render. I like this detail. So, light setup. This is the room. It's actually the same room and was taken the picture. This is some clip-on from IKEA and some boxes. So there are like three lights only. So these are some crops from APR, from Peter Sanitra. Thank you. You will see them in the reflection, I'm sure. And the direct light. That was a specialty there that I created. First I tried to really shine through trees, but it was super slow to tweak, so I just took a screen grab from a light point of view and I just painted where I want the light, even did this map in HDR, so I was able to have some nice values over the one and see some highlights, like here, you know, is the reflection of the window, so there are some overbrightened areas and some dark areas, and I was able to lit everything I wanted to, and that was nice. Yeah. Some references I took along, I had like 1,000 files I just picked to, which are nice. Some studies, one might say, this is a scan. I find out that this is the best thing for a proportion. If it's flat enough, you just can scan it, and it really helps. Some details of the real shelf, some measurements, really, it's a science, you know. Again, something that's in the final image. Yeah. Blah, 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 blah.